Now, let us take the derivation in continuation with the previous part, where we have divided the sequence x of n into even number of samples and odd number of samples. As x of k is expressed basically from n equal to 0 to n minus 1, now this summation we are splitting into two parts, that is one part which contain only even numbered samples and other part which contain only odd number samples. Now, wherein n we are going to replace with 2 times r for the first part of summation as a representation of even index samples, and n equal to 2r plus 1 we are going to replace for the second part of summation as an indication of odd indexed samples. So we could see in the basic formula there are places where original small n was there at x of n and w to the power n. In both first part of summation and second part of summation, now both of them, the places will get a replacement as 2r for the first part of summation and 2r plus 1 for the second part of summation. In the further simplification, here with w raised to 2 into r times k is rearranged as w to the power 2 and the whole raised to r times k. Similarly, for the second half of summation, it comprises of two fiddle factor parts. One part is w raised to 2 times rk to the base n, other part is w to the base k to the part n, to the base function n. Now, this second part of fiddle factor is not containing any r index, therefore we are taking it outside the summation as a constant value. Then in the first part of the summation, we have x of 2r into w raised to 2, and also in the second part we have x of 2r plus 1 into w raised to 2, where this bracketed function where it is w raised to 2, in both places we are going to further replace by w raised to l to the base n by 2, where l is r times k. So we have seen one of the twiddle factor properties in periodicity of twiddle factor, as w to the base n for the power 2 can be equivalently replaced as w to the base n by 2. It means if we are expressing this factor as w raised to 2 to the base 8, then it is equivalent to write w raised to 1 to the base 4. So that means that this w of 8, we are replacing it with the smaller indexed fiddle factor number, that is w base 4. Where now both of the parts in the overall x of k representation, it represents n by 2 point DFT formulas. So this first part completely represents g of k, since we have assigned x of 2r as g of r and x of 2r plus 1 as h of r. Now this g of k and h of k are the DFTs of those two time domain sequences. So now we are going to replace this x of k with a new expression as g of k plus w raised to k to the base n h of k. And these computations are only for half of the DFT samples, that is, this is a 4 point DFT sample and the other one is a 4 point DFT sample calculations for example of n equal to 8. So that means we are getting only half of the x of k samples out of the relation g of k plus w times h of k. In order to compute remaining half number of DFT samples, we are going to make use of the periodicity property of DFT with the period of n by 2. So g of k is equal to g of k plus n by 2, Similarly, h of k is also equal to h of k plus n by 2. And further, using the periodicity property of the Tweddle factor, where w raised to k plus n by 2, since we are in the second part of derivation, to calculate the higher powers of x of k, we are replacing k with k plus n by 2. So ultimately, this w raised to k, k becomes k plus n by 2, and according to the periodicity property of Tweddle factor, it is equivalent to writing minus w raised to k to the base n. Hence, we get a new relation to compute higher order index of x of k as g of k minus w raised to k to the base n into h of k. Now that we have come up with two set of equations, one set is for lower index of x of k calculation, where g of k and h of k, they are related with an additive relation, wherein to compute for the higher order index of x of k, g of k and h of k are related with a subtractive relation. Now, considering the n equal to 8 example, x of k, where k goes from 0 to n by 2 minus 1, by substituting these values in equation A, we will be able to get capital X of 0 up to x of 3. And these computations are carried out by replacing the respective index numbers of gk and h of k. So accordingly, you will see that x of k's from 0 to 3 are expressed as additions between g of 0, h of 0, g1, h1, g2, h of 2, g3 and h of 3, where each of the h of term is getting multiplied with a respective Tweddle factor component. Now from equation B, we can infer the higher order values of x of k, that is from x of 4 up till x of 7, which according to this equation B, we are simply going to obtain by changing the additions from the first set of equations by subtraction operator. You could see that all the terms, they remain same, only the addition is getting replaced with the subtraction. Now this relationship, the mathematical relationship starting from capital X of 0 till capital X of 7 is expressed as a graphical representation. It's shown as a graphical representation, which is termed as a butterfly diagram. So at the end of first stage of decimation, these relationships as a butterfly diagram takes up a form as shown in this diagram, where an entire 8-point DFT computation problem is broken up into two 4-point DFT subproblem, and each 4-point DFT is releasing a set of g of k and h of k respectively, and taking up input as even indexed samples for the first 4-point DFT block and odd indexed samples as the second 4-point DFT block. So in this computation, these cross markings, they indicate the flow of data from input towards output. Say for example, as you are computing capital X of 0, and capital X of 0 we seen earlier is obtained by adding g of 0. The arrow points out the flow of the data. Then at these dots, the addition will take place between this g of 0 term and a product term, which is h of 0 into w raised to 0 to the base n, where n here is 8. And in this way, capital X of 1 is obtained as G1 plus H1 into W1. Similarly, X2 is G2 plus H2 into W2, and so on, we are going to obtain up to X of 7. When we look up a case of X of 4, X of 4 is obtained by combining a term G of 0 and a term which is a product term H of 0 and W raised to 0, where a subtraction takes place between these two terms, and this subtraction is realized with the help of a minus 1 as the value what we are putting at the node where these two points will meet, which represents, minus 1 represents the product term H and W. It is taking up a negative sign as it is getting multiplied with minus 1. So ultimately X of 4 becomes a subtractive combination between these two terms. And similarly is the case for X of 5, X of 6 and X of 7.